give you a healing phrase to help with this, but it's not as simple as that. The biggest point is to bring what you need into your now moment. So by this, you can make money doing anything. You can make money doing anything. Now, I know you need a job specifically, but if you're already making money doing things, then it takes the pressure off of the need for the job and it becomes effortless for the job to come to you. What I mean by this is, like, if you do tarot, go live if you can, or go on Instagram or make a post saying like $5 for a card or something like this. If you don't do that, sell some items in your home. I'm sure you have a skill set that I am not aware of that you can sell, you know, for money. When you're in a state of lack or worry or panic or desperation, it doesn't bode well for your, like, I guess what people would call manifesting. But basically it's your energy. Ugh, I hate using the word frequency, but it's kind of like that. It's like what you're putting out, you're getting back. So that's the first part. Second part, I would recommend my playlist, TikTok playlist, which is the, it's just called like $3 signs, like, and it's about bringing your abundance into your reality. Okay, now, you need a job by Sunday. So I'm just going to write out a bunch of things here, and I'm just going to keep talking so that I have enough time in the video for all the things I'm going to type, because I'm going to type a lot. I'm going to type a lot of things. But without that basic core structure, you need to understand that you already have the money and that you're making the money and that making money is easy and that you don't have desperation. Also, personal experience, I'm going to keep talking while I do this. Personal experience, there was a time in my life where I needed a job so fucking badly that I would bomb every interview. And I would be like, just hire me for free for like 2 days. Let me prove my worth. Let me show you that I can do it. And you'll love me. You'll see. And the customers will love me. Just give me a chance. Put me in, coach. And they were like, this bitch is fucking crazy. And I did not get a job. I actually had to go to therapy for it, because I was like, I don't know what the fuck I'm doing wrong. And if the therapist would have just said, hey, you're being desperate and needy, I would have been like, oh, shit. Okay, that makes sense. That makes sense. But yeah, they didn't tell me that, so they, because I was paying them, so why would they? All right, bye. Okay, so this has come up a couple of times. By the way, I'm so glad that you did the things. That's fucking awesome. Okay, hand gestures. So there are a few people that, instead of saying the phrase to access their healings or access their, you know, whatever, if they're out in public and they need something, you can set the healings, or you can set your house cleanse, or you can set whatever the fuck it is, or the balancing of the energies, to a hand gesture. That way you can just kind of go scratch like this and the thing will go. Or you can do like anime, like whoo-wah kind of stuff. You can do it while you're driving. Just go like this. That could equal your trigger phrase for it to go. It's just a tangible thing that puts you in control. It does not have to be a phrase or a sentence like I do. And a lot of you are not comfortable being a fucking weirdo out in public like I am. So just doing a little might be what you need to get your healings to work. I'm going to make a part two and show you how to do this. Okay, so we're going to set up a healing. I'm going to walk you through making a healing, and then we're going to do a hand gesture to it instead of a phrase. So what I want you to do is picture tubes coming off of your body. Instead of cords, like cutting cords, it's tubes where people have, like, you gave a little bit of yourself away and they pulled too much out, so siphoned off of you. So when you do this, you want to cleanse and purify the energy before you bring it back. You're going to say, Spirit, if it's in my highest good, please cleanse and purify and bring back all energy, abilities, money, love, self-empowerment that I gave too much away of or has been siphoned from me. Pull it back to me at this time. Okay, so now that that's all back, you're going to have these tubes on you, and you're going to say, Spirit, please disconnect and disintegrate these tubes back to their rightful owners. Great. All of this is creating a healing, but they're, yeah, okay. So now I I want you to think of it. Like, all those people that connected to you, you gave them a port. You gave them an opening for them to connect to you. So you've got, like, plug outlets or ports on you. So you're going to say, Spirit, please remove all hardware for me that does not belong. Now, I want you to look down at your left arm, and you're going to see a port where that one of the tubes was coming off of. That's bright. Okay, you're going to see like a port. What I want you to do with your right hand, if you know the Avatar movie, the Blue Alien, where they do the... I want you to put your right hand over your arm, and I want you to start seeing the muscles, the tendons, the blood, the bone, the skins all merging back together. And that is a healing, right? Okay, so then now you're going to say, Spirit, please copy and paste that all over my body where needed. Okay, now we're going to set this up to a hand gesture instead of a phrase. Oh, that's perfect. Let's go. Sheesh. When you do that, that whole system's going to start again with your energy. Okay. Okay, bye. I feel like this is something that happens to a lot of people. I wish I had known that I could change things earlier, the lives that were lost, the things that could have changed. So first of all, I want you to do this. Spirit, please remove all guilt and shame from me. Wrap it in love, light, and forgiveness. Return it to its rightful owners at this time. You're going to feel quite a bit leave. Okay, that's the first part. An example I use is the Titanic, okay? So yes, it was a disaster. Yes, lots of people died. But when they look back at it, the reason it was such a tragedy is all the things they could have done that they didn't do. They could have had more boats. They could have put more people in those boats. So things of that nature. I have a series. It's called Healing Your Current. And it's a TikTok playlist. And I'm going to tag this one to it. But also, if you go to my YouTube, there are a couple of videos. There's a quick link to my YouTube in my link tree. And in my website, which is catandboots138.com. If you look at, I'll write them on the screen, Miracles Are Future You, or Miracles is how it's titled now, Why We Heal Trauma and Rewriting History, it's going to click so many things into perspectives for you. All time is now. You don't need to beat yourself up for the things that you couldn't heal. You just want to heal as much of it as possible so that when their energy body exists again, because all time is now, but when it reincarnates, they don't have amnesia and they're able to heal it faster. I hope this made sense. Okay, goodbye. Hey, you can currently go to my link tree or directly to catandboots138.com. I'll write it on the screen here and I'll write it in the what the fuck is that called? Captions. That's what it's called. Yeah, descriptions. Okay. We could do past life, we could do inner child, we can do deep-rooted issues. There are three different options currently. I have tree trimming, that is one major issue, like one past life, something like this. I have root detangle, which is 2 to 3. And then I have the bountiful harvest, which is as much as we can cover in 2 hours. All of those options are available. I don't take payment until after the session. This clears the energy and makes sure that I'm the right healer for you. And then I accept through Cash App and PayPal at this time. Okay. Thanks. Bye. Hey, if you go to my link tree, I will eventually have it on YouTube, but right now I don't. If you go to my link tree and you go to the tab that's like a key, and then it says Inner Child, Past Life, Akashic Library, there's a series in there specifically to help you when you get a past life reading from somebody else. And it's literally the steps on how to clear that stuff for yourself, how to ask to go to which thing that you need to, which life you need to. It's all written out there for you step by step. And you can kind of follow along with me or... you know, write it out or go into meditative trance state or go to sleep to do it, however is conducive for you.
I do believe that series is available in my playlist and insight series as well, and it's labeled. But yeah, there's a quick link to it in my link tree. Okay, I hope that helps. Keep me posted. Okay, bye.
Hey, I don't know offhand what session we had. I'd have to be refreshed on who you are, and then I'd be able to remember it. But I will say, usually during my sessions, if I help someone create a healing, I usually walk them through how to create it themselves. So that's the first part. I didn't make a healing for you. I most likely, 98% sure, I would help you create your own. Now, for me, when I create a healing, I prefer to have my soul fragment out to do the work it needs while allowing my human to remain human. So that's this phrase right here. And the second part, I would say, I go through and I clean off my healings all the time. It's kind of like cleaning the things that clean you. And I just use the steps that are written out in the house cleanse. I have them memorized, but it's like, please, spirit, please remove all magic mirages, dark, like all the things from my healings. Again, they're written out in the house cleanse. Okay, thanks, bye. Here's your reminder that every choice you make is a vote for the kind of world you want to live in. Woo!